Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working With Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about doing the weekly planning session. Now this is something I get asked a lot about, particularly via email and anyone using the time sector system. In GTD speak, this is the weekly review. In time sector system, it's the weekly planning session because essentially you're not really reviewing anything, you're planning the week ahead. And that's what I want to show you this week. I want to show you the different components of doing a weekly planning session so that you set yourself up for an amazingly productive week. Okay, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo account now and I will show you how I would do or how I do a weekly planning session. Okay, when I do my weekly review, this is where I start. I start in my purpose and objectives board because this is giving me the overview for this week and this month and this quarter. Now, the first thing is I've actually updated this just to save some time. But the first place is I like to have a look at my objectives for the week, this second column, because I want to see, have I achieved my objectives for the week? Now, this is my objectives for next week and my focus. Well, this hasn't changed for a while because this is what I'm doing. I'm trying to make sure I do my exercise 7 days a week. And the focus has to be my email mastery course because that needs to be completed. So I can have a quick look here. We're right at the end of the month now. So we're looking at, like, have I done this? Yes, I'm right into the process of doing that. And I have actually achieved that. And I can check that off if I wish. Normally I don't. I just change that because this is going to be a new month, as in from the 1st of March. So I'll be looking at down here to see what my objective is going to be for March. So this is really where I start my weekly planning session. Just spend a couple of minutes in here just to have a look to see what do I want to get accomplished next week? What are my real objectives? Next place I would go to then is my inbox and clear out anything, just process anything that's in there that needs processing. Doesn't take long, usually takes me 4 or 5 minutes, but just to go in there and just clean that up and get it done. Once I've done that, then it's a matter of going into my this week here. Now, I've got 15 recurring areas of focus, so those are set every week. I don't need to check those because these just happen when they need to happen. By the way, what I do like to do, normally I do have dates in here. This is just my demo account. So these would be dated. So let's just make sure this is how it would be look. So let's say that's today, and we're going to do that one for tomorrow. So this is how it would look. So hopefully at the end of the week, you have managed to get this number down to round about between 2 or 3 or 4 tasks, not too many. If you've got more than 10 tasks left in this week on a Saturday or Sunday, then you've got big problems. You're over-scheduling yourself and you need to have a look at this because you can't keep doing that to yourself every single week. You know, there's no point in saying, I want to do this, I want to do this, I want to do this, if you just never have the time to do it. You know, step back a bit and start being more realistic about what you can get accomplished each week. 2 is a good number, particularly say for a Friday or a Saturday, maybe 5 or 6 on a Friday, but you want to get them done. What I also like to do is I like to change the sort in my this week to by due date, because then I can see what I have coming up. So here, these are, as I say, my recurring areas of focus. So it doesn't really matter when those are done. This is the main part when I'm doing my weekly planning session, what's been done. And let's just say these are going to get done. Next place I go to is my next week. Now notice in my next week, there is nothing in there that's dated. Now, if you remember, when we go back to the purpose on objectives, one of the purpose of objectives is right here, the email mastery course. And I have my email mastery course floating project. So that's going to be the first thing that goes into this week. At this point, remember, I'm not dating, if you notice. These need to be chased, so I'm going to move that into this week. What you can do, by the way, and I love this, is if you on a Mac, if you do command click And you can now go through these core collections. I need to do that, so I can click on that. I'm not going to, that obviously doesn't need doing. Follow up with Fred, yes, need to do that. Buy collapsible table, no, I can wait. Find out if it costs, I can wait. I'm going to get that finished next week and I will finish that. So once I've done this, so whatever I've got in next week doesn't necessarily mean it has to be moved forward. What I'm going to do now is move to project. I'm going to move that to this week and that's it. These ones here, I've already now decided I'm not going to do next week, so I don't need to worry. Now I go into my this week and these are the ones without date. So right here, I'm going to date that for Monday because it's going to be my priority. Continue life coaching course. Well, Tuesdays are usually my day off, so I'm going to do that on Tuesday. Now, those things that I know are going to be important, but the next thing I do before I finish off dating these, I go into my calendar because here is where I get to see what's really going on in my week. And I've got two of those in there, so remove one. So these are the things that I want to have a look at. Now, this is my basic structure. It's roughly about what my basic structure is each week. And I'm looking here for any gaps. Now, this here is my day off, and I already know that on Tuesday we are going over to Seoul. So I'm just going to drag that out because that's going to be all day. So I can just go in there and just say in Seoul. And I do this. I don't make this an all-day event. I just have this as a physical event because there may be time right here that I could do something with. So that's how I've done that. So that's now blocked off. And now I'm looking for the gap. So I'm thinking, okay, Monday afternoon's looking good. Wednesday afternoon's looking good. Thursday and Friday is always a bit tight because of the recording. So I know that for these things here, like follow up Jeff, I can do that one on Monday. So I can just go here and click that for Monday. I can follow up Fred again. We're going to do that. Schedule that for Monday because I know now that I've got plenty of time on Monday for this. So when I'm looking at this, I've noticed that I've got quite a few, like Chase SD, that's another communication. So I'm grouping these together and I'm seeing that Call Pete, there's another one. So I'm going to do that on Monday as well. Let's get Monday a really strong day. And call Claire if she needs any other documents before the end of the year. I will just do that. And I do that one on Wednesday, just to give me a bit of space. So these are sorted by due date. So now I know that I've got a lot of communications to do on Monday. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my calendar and I'm going to actually create a communications. So again, there's a few follow-ups, there's a few emails. So I'm just going to call this communications time. I'm not going to be more specific than that. And I'm just going to block that off on my calendar because there's quite a few communications that need doing. So I block that off between 3 and 5 p.m. That's a good time to do that. And there's another one which I've got for Wednesday, which is a bit... So I'm going to do a one-hour communications time on Wednesday because I know I'm going to have a bit of following up to do. So let's just do that for 1 hour on Tuesday. I'm sorry, on Wednesday. And so that's how I'm going to do. So what I'm looking at now is I've got this email mastery, which is a really important thing. It's flagged red. So when it comes up on Monday, it's going to be red. So I need to make sure I've got time for that. So I'm going to put that in here. I want to block that off. It's a really important thing to do. So I'm going to do that 1:15, work on email mastery course, and I'm going to make that to there, and I'm also going to copy that, and I'm going to do I won't do that in the evening, but I will, let's move, see, this is why the calendar is such a good tool. So I'm going to give myself a 15-minute break after that. That's what I'm going to be working on there anyway, so I'm going to finish that off in the afternoon. So I'm just going to copy that down to round about there and take that to 5:30. And that should give me enough time to do my email mastery course. So this is how you bring in your calendar and Todoist at the same time. And that's it. So it's all scheduled. I know now I have enough time to get all these tasks done. And that's essentially how I'm doing my weekly planning session. So remember, I'm not going to pick and choose on various projects. All I need to know is, do I have enough time to work on the project that I want to work on next week, which is my email mastery course? And I've got plenty of time here and I've got time there. That should get it right up to where I want it to be. Plus, I've got all these tasks which I've scheduled for communication, because a lot of that is communication. So that's all in here. So I've actually got myself set up now for a week where I know I've got enough time to get all my work done. And that's it. I don't need to worry about anything else. Everything's dated. I know there's enough time on my calendar to get these things done, and I'm going to get them done. Okay, there's emergencies will crop up during the week, and that's inevitable because it's called life and you can't avoid it. But at least you now have the opportunity to know that when you've finished the planning, that you've got enough time to get your work done. And that's it. So there you go. That's how I would do my weekly planning session. It takes me around about 20 to 30 minutes, because I do generally go and have a look at my other projects in Evernote. But for all intents and purposes, that's how Todoist and my calendar work together. I hope you've got some value from this. And thank you very much for watching. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now, I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system, that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.